One cold and dreary Friday afternoon, five young students set out on a mission that they would never forget, a mission that would change their lives forever. It all started with one goal, one purpose, one mission, to feed.
Wait, Tracy, look at me. Wait. So, the first 5 minutes we're here, David manages to slice his finger open. And he keeps peeling the orange. It's not very hygienic. Public health, David. Come on.
Public health, David. Public health.
Public health, David. You gotta learn to be hygienic. Way to keep up on your public health, Tracy.
Okay, let me go rinse my finger and my shirt. Oh, great.
To see it again?
It's good! I can't help it!
Do you want me to look at you or the camera?
Camera?
Okay.
It'd be like The Office when I'm looking at you and then I look at you.
I love that show.
So last question.
Okay.
What do you do?
Okay, take two.
What do you do for the church? I am one of the three ministers on the staff of the church, and my job is here at the church, at the Brick Church, where I'm a minister, is to work with education and specifically to work with children, youth, adolescents, and adults in educational programs. So one of the things that I do is teach confirmation class, and a lot of the students who are in confirmation were here tonight, and I also help run this Friday night dinner program that a lot of the students come to and help out with.
And our second question is,
my second question is,
how do you pick what food you want to make for the night, and how do you go out and prepare that?
Yeah, this means you didn't like my food, right?
No.
We love the food. How I pick it, basically, it needs to be a meal that is generally healthy, that our residents will like, and that is easy to prepare with a bunch of different people. It means you have to have enough jobs, so it has to be sort of complicated enough that you like to have lots of things to chop up and cook. But it can't be something that would be easy to mess up, because when you have too many cooks in the kitchen, if you have a really complicated meal, like you're making a souffle or something, you're bound to fail. So we tend to do things like a chicken casserole or a big noodle dish or every once in a while a big soup or something.
All right, what if we're vegetarian?
We have no vegetarian guests, but we do have a number of guests who don't eat pork, so we never serve pork or bacon, or if we do, we have an alternative. And we tend not to serve red meat.
Sorry, I was holding it.
Hold the camera.
I was holding it the whole time. I felt it coming. I was like, no, can't ruin interview.
Okay.
We don't serve red meat usually, partly because it's not very healthy, but also because it's just a lot more expensive. So, generally speaking, chicken is the meat of Friday night dinner program.
All right, and one more question. Where do you get the money to go out and buy food, and what's the budget?
Yeah, the money is budgeted by the church, and all of the money comes out of donations that the church members give to the church. So every year, all of our church members, there are about 1,800 people in the church, they make a pledge and they say, I'm going to give this much money this year. And they have a whole year to fulfill that pledge. But in the meantime, at the church, we drop a budget and we say, people have promised us, say, $1 million to cover everything. So then we divide up that budget and we go, all right, Friday Night Dinner Program is going to have, $15,000 for the year. And then we divide that into how many nights we have, and we go, all right, we have $100 to spend on groceries every night that we have Friday night dinner, something like that. We actually spend about $100 to $150 on each meal here at Friday night dinner program, but occasionally a family will volunteer to run the evening, and a lot of times they won't turn in their receipts, and they'll just say, this is our gift. So they'll spend $150, and then they just won't ask for reimbursement.
How often do you have these Friday night dinners?
They happen every night, every Friday night during the school year. But every other Friday night, it's run by the youth. So this group runs it every other Friday night. The second and fourth and maybe sometimes the fifth Friday of the month is run by a group of people, officers in the church called deacons. But the deacons don't actually run it. They get volunteer families to come and put it together. So it might be like a dad and a mom and two kids who come and cook it, in which case our guests aren't overwhelmed by the volunteers the way they are tonight.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks for your help. You were really good. Good job.
Thanks.